In 1981, The Evil Dead was released, and it launched the career of two men, director Sam Raimi and the King of B himself, Bruce Campbell.
Housewares.
Bruce has had a cult following for his never-ending part as Ash in the Evil Dead franchise, and while it has garnered him some fame and recognition in the business, he has still been passed on for some major roles that would have put him into a new limelight. One of the more intriguing ones was the role of Shooter McGavin in the movie Happy Gilmore. Bruce had been up for the role and almost got it, but the studio went with Christopher McDonald. And while Christopher McDonald did do a great job, he originally turned down the role twice before taking it. It would have been great to see Bruce counter Sandler on the green delivering those iconic one-liners. But this wasn't the first time the studio passed on Bruce. Early on, after the success of Evil Dead, Sam and Bruce would go on to work together with the Coen brothers on a film called Crime Wave. This would be one of many times Sam would go to the plate for his lifelong friend Bruce. Raimi had wanted him to play the lead role, but the studio wanted someone who was more Hollywood. So instead, Sam gave Campbell a supporting role and expanded the character's part so that Bruce would get more screen time. And while Bruce did get a co-producer credit for the film, the production isn't looked back fondly on by him. He has gone on to say, quote, "The film never released, it escaped." While it wasn't the best time for him, he still went on to work on another film with the Coen brothers called The Hudsucker Proxy.
Old mother routine.
Adenoids.
Lumbago.
That gag's got whiskers on it.
Raimi again would want Bruce to star as a lead in another film of his called Darkman. But once again, the studio did not want him and thought that he couldn't handle it. So they casted a different actor at the time, Liam Neeson, who is a famous actor now, but not because of this role.
He has the power to look like any man.
This to a both sons of witches!
But he is unlike any man.
While the film isn't regarded as the best, it's still worth a watch. But Raimi being Raimi had Bruce end up in the final scene as the lead, probably as a rib to the studio for not wanting to cast him as it. These are just a couple of cases where Bruce was looked over for a part. In his career, he screen tested for the lead of The Phantom, was the first choice as the dad in Pet Sematary, and was considered for parts like Jack Tavern in Speed, They Live as the Drifter, Jurassic Park as Dr. Malcolm, and even Pretty Woman, where he would have starred across Julia Roberts. It's easy to see why he was considered for these roles, because a lot of them have great one-liners, especially Dr. Malcolm's role in Jurassic Park.
But life, finds a way.
But it wasn't just movies. Bruce has had a very successful career on TV, including working on productions like Xena, Hercules, and starring in his own shows like Jack of All Trades and The Adventures of Briscoe County Jr., where he supposedly got the role by being able to judo throw himself, something he would go on to do multiple times during the audition process before landing the job. One job he didn't land, though, was the role of Agent Doggett, the character that would replace David Duchovny's Agent Mulder on the show X-Files. Bruce would have made a terrific choice fitting well into the paranormal vibe of the 90s show. But it would have messed with the timeline a bit, as Campbell has played a baby-making demon in an earlier season, a plot that sounds like something straight out of a Ryan Murphy show. While he didn't land that role, he went on later to co-star in another successful TV show, Burn Notice, where he played retired Navy SEAL Sam Axe. The show had 7 seasons and even a TV movie starring Bruce's character Sam.
We got firearms and we got snacks.
And while he may be done now, with Ash vs. the Evil Dead being his last acting role, he is still working, writing screenplays and a new book. Being lifelong friends with Sam Raimi didn't hurt either, as it ensured him cameos in just about all of his films. At this point, if there's a Sam Raimi film, it's bound to have his car and Bruce Campbell in it. Not only did he appear as cameos in all of Sam's Spider-Man films, but he was even considered to be the main villain in Spider-Man 4, but the movie never happened. Bruce is a no-nonsense actor. What you see is what you get, and what you get is a great actor who knows his role and how to make it. During his 4 decades in the business, he has been an actor, writer, producer, director, and has written 2 books. While Bruce didn't manage to land some of these roles, it still didn't stop him from making an impact on the industry with the ones that he did. It didn't matter what the role, what the job. Bruce was gonna knock it out of the park, because that's what good actors do. People tend to make fun of low-budget movies, often because they lack the smooth sophistication of slick Hollywood fare. But what the average viewer fails to recognize is that low-budget movies with almost nothing to lose are far more likely to push the creative envelope. Thanks a lot for watching, and until next time, I'll see you on the internet.